Guys, welcome back. We're out here on the deck. I've been busy since early this morning. Okay, what is a good neighbor? I try to be a good neighbor. So do mine. They're all pretty decent people. And some of the things that I'm doing to secure my home kind of helps them out also. Like this morning, earlier a few days ago, I set up some security lighting out here in the backyard. And I noticed some flaws in it, so I came out here early this morning after several days of observing and readjusted everything so that now it's provides security lighting for my neighbors and myself. You know, I think that's a pretty good thing to do. And I wanted to answer some comments about this bonsai tree behind me. I'm doing this to be a good neighbor because I saw these neighbors. I haven't shook their hands yet. They're a couple from India, and in the house right now, as far as I know, there's the mom and a grandma, and she has a young son. He's probably 3 or 4 years old. From what I've observed, the husband is working out of town, and he comes home on the weekends. So some additional lighting in their place, and for them to be able to see my house and I can see their house is a way that I can keep an eye on them. Because I know that the lady of the house is probably nervous being there alone all the time because she keeps her lights on 24/7, you know. And I can understand that because she's pretty much alone. And I'd be more than happy to keep an eye on the back of her house for any prowlers or any peeping toms or whatever else is out there. But I'm going to ask you guys this, and I find this really strange, or how do I describe it? I find that this is kind of a preparedness channel, kind of not. It's more or less like a daily vlog about what I'm doing, because I've got family across the Atlantic, and I've got family across the Pacific, and they watch, and this is a way for them to keep track of what we're doing, how we're doing over here in the States. But I went on to a panel today, Saturday morning, and the host is a Swede, and the co-host is a Canadian. Guys are cool. They're really cool guys. And they got some good guests, and it's a preparedness channel. And there was a fella who came onto the channel and telling me I did everything wrong, and because, you know, I stood my ground in my last house with a sidearm on, told me I was an idiot, make every mistake in the world by showing him that I have a firearm. Well, you know, you look around my neighborhood here, and we've all got, you know, above average income level with more than one story homes. And, the criminals know that we're armed. They already know. But by showing my sidearm, standing in my garage door, making them leave, gets the word out. Don't go to that guy's house, because I never saw the same guy twice. Never did. They never came back. So I'm asking, you know, is it, later on we had a discussion on the same panel that there's probably less than 1% of people on YouTube that are real and genuine. Like the old toothless guy who came on to scold me about how incompetent I am, toothless, said that I'm part of the problem because I'm running away. I told him that we're going to move overseas. We planned on moving over to the Philippines before there was a YouTube. And I'm part of the problem because I'm running away. And come to find out later on, while he's sitting there in his trailer, that he lives so far out in the desert. I live way out in the desert. And one of the British that was on the panel asked him, how far are you away from medical care? And he said, maybe 5 or 6 hours if the helicopters can find me, because they'll get lost coming this far out. I'm completely off the grid. So who's really running away? That guy or me? I've had these plans in place for years. I love the Philippines and the Filipino people. But there's some really fucked up people on YouTube. There really are. There's so many, because of course that guy had to say that he was special forces in the Army, and he was also a career law enforcement for, 75 years. And it's like, I don't believe you. I got angry and I flipped the guy off, and I had to get up and walk away and get a coffee, because I won't disrespect someone else's life. I won't do that. Well, try not to anyway. And it's so hard to learn anything genuine here on YouTube. And so that's why when I find a good channel, I stay with them, no matter whether it's gardening, building furniture, welding, preparedness, whatever it is, if they're a good, honest, genuine channel, I stay with them. But the BS, unsubscribe. You're gone very quickly, very quickly, especially the liars. People here, they feel that they have to overinflate themselves to sound like they're really an official whatever. And you're not. And you're not fooling anyone. So, that's my comments. Thank you for watching. Peace out. Have a good weekend.